Leading. So this is a case of where it's really hard for me to make up problems, especially when we don't have features. We're only doing everything based on segments. So you just have to bear with me with these ridiculous cases, because I drove myself crazy with these. So again, this isn't the, it's not like if I gave this to you, I'd expect you to be able to figure it out. I'm just going to tell you the analysis that I had in mind, and we're going to see what's going on. Okay? So let's say I did this segmentation, and I got three roots. I've got fish, he's always ooh. The plural is this T prefix, okay? That's always the plural. And the singular is a P prefix, except here, something funny is going on. And what else? What's the K? The K is four, the N is on, and yeah, N is on. N is always on, K is always four. T is singular, and no, T is always plural, and the singular is either a P or a T. Okay, so this is kind of ridiculous. So the plural is what? It's always a T prefix, and singular is either a P or a T. So what do you think is the rule? Is it going to be a P to T rule or a T to P rule?
Right?
The plural is definitely T. The singular is either P or T. But it's got to behave different from this. So it better be a P. So we need a rule P to T. So we're going to have a really stupid rule that says P becomes T before O. Yeah, let's do that. All right, P becomes T before O. Yeah. Okay. Notice that this is ooh, ooh, ooh. And this dish, you guys know what a knish is? It's like a Jewish potato pastry. Doesn't matter. You can get in New York all the time. Right, the okay. This is either U or O. But it can't be U, so it must be O.
Oh.
Right. So we got P to T before O. But since this is an O, why isn't it an O here and here? Well, it must be that we had a rule. Remember, I'm just going to give this to you. O becomes U before N. Okay? So if this is that P should become T before, P should become T before O, why don't we get a T here? Because this is an underlying O. And there P becomes T before O. So we gotta make sure that this P doesn't become a T. How can we do it? Yeah, rule ordering, but how? So this is a bleeding ordering in this ridiculous example I made up. Okay, there's our analysis. There's the lexical entries. Just take my word for it. And here's the rules. And if we first, which one is it? We go there. Which rule has to apply first? I guess that's one.
Oh,
yeah. So it's be 1, 2, right? So if we first do O to U for N, then these will become U's, and then this P doesn't change. Why do we have a T here? Why do we have a T here? It's just the underlying formula, right? Why do we have a T here? It's the underlying P that became a T. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't happen here. Why do we have a P here?
That's the singular?
Yes.
That's
why do we have a P here?
The singular?
Why do we have a P here?
Singular.
Why do we have a P here?
Singular.
Why do we have a P here?
Because of the rule.
No.
Singular?
It's a singular marker, and it didn't get changed into a T because the environment got destroyed.
Oh, okay.
Because the O became a U. So that's bleeding. You take away. Okay, so now you're all going to be confused about the difference between counterfeeding and bleeding. So bleeding is like I come and I say, everybody open your wallets, and I take $5 from each of you. I just bled you of $5, right? That's different from saying, open your wallets, and then I just leave. And I fail to feed you each $5. Like if I fed you $5, you would all leave here, I don't know, what do you have, $1,000 in your wallet? You would leave here with $1,005 each. If I fed you. If I counterfed you, if I just didn't do anything, you would still have $1,000. But if I bleed you all of $5, what do you end up with?
$995,
right? So failing, so destroying is different from failing to create.